this is a beautiful sight, as you can see right here. All three pyramids. And how many pyramids in the Giza Plateau?
Nine.
And who do they always forget?
The Queens.
The Queens. So you see the three in Mecca Rock beside there. You see the Queens. Also is Tough Rock. So that would make nine pyramids in the Giza Plateau. So we always got to deal with the Queens, because in Kemet it's dealt with what? Spiritual, dialectical laws of opposites. So you're not going to see two kings together in ancient Kemet. You're not going to be two queens together. All right? That's Western madness. All right? Madness, chaos. Chaos, you can manipulate people, you can control people. All right, but in Kemet, it was based off of the spiritual laws of offices. So for to have a king, you're going to have a queen. Again, as we can see clearly when you're looking out here, it looks like Khufu's pyramid is smaller, but it's not smaller. It's just his son Khufu built his on a higher plateau. But in the architectural structure that we're looking at here, everything was built based off of a spiritual connection with the cosmos. That means that our ancestors had a spiritual connection to their ascension and to the spiritual realm associated with the constellation of Orion. Now, when our ancestors were building these structures, they saw that the constellation of Orion, as I said, seven stars, three stars in the belt. When the constellation of Sebel Septa, that means the star system Ceres, as the Romans would call it, the Greeks call it Sophis. When that star rose, that represented who? A Set. And then when the Orion arose, the constellation of Orion, that was a Sar. So even the spiritual balance they saw in the cosmos. And when that star rose and Orion rose, something else happened in the cosmos. That means that also Ra rose. And who is Ra? Personified is who? Haru. So here the spiritual story is told in the cosmos. So the layout of this whole layout that you see here, especially when we get down to the last site, and that is Ra, Haru, and Akhet. He's looking to the east. Looking to the east in the constellation of Leo, the lion. He's in a recumbent lion form. Because he represents who? Haru. Haru and Akhet. Haru and the horizon. So as he is looking out in the constellation of Orion, the constellation of Leo, symbolically, that star, that constellation is going to Orion. So Haru is going back to his father to raise his son, to raise his father from the Grand Master's grip of the lion's paw. Why is he going to raise him? Because who killed us all?
His brother.
So long before the Cain and Abel story, here we see the evil brother is killing the good brother. Okay? And it's going to be the son who's going to raise his father by the Grand Master's grip of the lion's paw. That's why you see Dreamstellar when we get down there, where rituals took place, where a king was symbolically raised, like Ben Kepparaja, he raised the fourth of the 18th dynasty, where he dug him from the sand. And that's going to be a mind-blowing experience when you see this colossus, the oldest on the planet Earth. Mind-blowing. They've documented now that colossal may be older than what it is, much older than what it is. Massive. I'm not going to talk too much on it because I want it to blow your mind when you get down there. All right? So this is spectacular, brothers and sisters. Now, I was telling you about that sister on the camel. See out there? See those poles out there?
Yeah.
That's where I saw her.
Oh, that's crazy.
Right when she was about to go down. See those poles?
Right,
that's where she was at with the camel. All right?